What's poppin', y'all? It looks like Juice WRLD's death is a lot sadder than people anticipated. His videographer went on a tweeting spree the other day, sharing details that I personally never heard before, and contradict a narrative that was posted throughout most media outlets. I find it a bit weird because why would they all assume something happened that didn't, and why wasn't it corrected earlier? But hey, I don't know. Jay did not swallow a bunch of pills because the police were at the airport. We gave no F's about them being there. He could have flushed them down the toilet if he cared. This was one of the most important points shared because the whole narrative that was being spread everywhere was that he panicked and swallowed a bunch of these pills that he had on him when the police arrived. This sounds fishy at first because, I mean, you've got 70 pounds of weed and a weapon, so why would the pills be a good idea to swallow knowing how damaging they are going to be to you? And I feel like he would have known that they were going to kill him. But when you see that story getting spread everywhere from every outlet, you just think to yourself, damn, maybe this really did happen, which is what I did. And when the autopsy came out, it said he had drugs in his system, mainly oxycodone and codeine, as well as promethazine and naloxone. I might have pronounced that last one wrong. I ain't no expert with drugs. Bear with me. Jay was just hooked bad. The amount he took daily was absurd, and he hid how much he really took from mostly everyone. Everyone around him tried really hard to get him to slow down. When he agreed to rehab, it was because he wanted to lower his tolerance. He didn't want to stop. Jay was supposed to go to rehab that month. We tried so hard to do positive things every day, like ride dirt bikes or paintball, to keep busy and not do pills, but every night, once he hit the studio, that was it. He loved it. I never thought he would OD. I was always scared of getting bad press pills, so got test strips. I tested every batch he got. But no one knew how much he really took because he was hiding it. Once Max and I really started counting how much he had and how fast he went through them. One thing that I really dislike is the whole notion that fans have whenever a rapper dies of, you should have done X, Y, and Z to prevent this. Why didn't you do this? Hindsight 2020. And in some rare cases, even blaming a close friend of the rapper for their death. We saw this exact same thing happen when Lil Peep died. And everyone harassed that dude Bexy, who just lost one of his best friends. They blamed him for the death, and he had to struggle with both the fans telling him it should have been him, it was all his fault, and dealing with the already devastating loss of his close friend. How are you supposed to help someone that doesn't want to help themselves? It's one thing if Juice WRLD had wanted to quit, and they were doing everything they could to make that process as smooth as possible, which they seemed like they were down to do. But he was adamant about not quitting, and it's not like they can babysit him 24/7. These are all individuals surrounding him that have their own lives to live. They didn't sign up for this, and I mean, they gotta go to sleep too, even if they're trying to be with him at all hours of the day. They can't be awake all day, and he can easily sneak drugs in during that time. Even when they said that they knew he was doing drugs, he was hiding the amount that he was doing. Plus, his girlfriend likely tried helping in whatever way she could. It's a really hard situation to be in, but I mean, he chose the lifestyle. I miss him so much. Every day I miss having someone to talk to that understood me and cared. I miss goofing off. I miss filming him freestyling for me because he knew I loved it. I miss making him Red Baron pizza at 3:30 a.m. and he liked it burned. Shoot, I miss rolling his blunts. I never did pills like that. Maybe occasionally take a half. They always scared me. I'd sip sometimes for sure. Now I want to take perks and sip and get messed up as possible to feel like those times when I actually did do it with him. I had to watch little bro die at my feet. I had to look in his eyes while he was dying, and I couldn't do anything about it. He had nothing to worry about. He knew the cops were there before we landed. We put that strap in my bag. It was all good. I had a clean record and I'm a registered owner. I had no problem taking that charge. That man treated me better than any other human on earth. Just on a personal level, he cared about me just like all of his friends. It was so genuine and pure. I had to watch Allie holding him screaming, losing the love of her life right in her arms. It's so hard to function sometimes. This has ruined me completely. It's ruined jobs, relationships. I don't think I'll ever feel normal again. I miss my brother. Man, why couldn't it have been me, not him? It sounds like this guy's really going through survivor's guilt. I've never experienced something like that. Hopefully, I never have to. But it must just leave such a gaping hole inside him that he tried to do everything he could to keep Juice WRLD safe within the realm that Juice wanted to operate in. He knew that Juice wasn't going to stop doing drugs. So what he did was say, well, if he's going to hide them from us, he may be doing bad pills that could kill him. So I'm going to get a tester to try to make sure that at least the pills he's doing aren't pressed with something else, which is how Lil Peep allegedly died. But that wasn't enough. And this is where I think fans really need to start reflecting on the way they address the people closest to the rappers that have died, because they go through it the most. It's unlikely to ever change, since the people that are doing the most harassing and attacking are usually children or really young teenagers. But I remember this whole thing going around blaming Juice WRLD's girlfriend for him dying. Now imagine that she's already going through it. The closest person to him that was with him nearly all the time. And now she's dealing with this loss and y'all are blaming her for it. It could have led her down a dark path too, and honestly, we don't know if it did or didn't. The reason why I say the scenario is sadder than we thought is because this wasn't some sort of freak accident that was described or that you could just chalk it up to blaming somebody for it. Like, oh, this could have been prevented easily. People were trying to blame the pilot, but he had nothing to do with it if Juice WRLD didn't swallow those pills in a panic like Chris Long claims he didn't. There's so many hypothetical what-ifs fans could come up with to cope if the death is some freak accident, like in the case of Lil Peep. But the way that it seems like things unfolded is that he just dropped dead because his body was no longer able to endure the amount of drugs that Juice WRLD was putting in his system. And there was nobody that could be blamed for this that was around him or on his team. What do you want them to do? I mean, tie him up like a prisoner or something? In that case, he would likely be in danger anyway from the withdrawal symptoms he would experience. And he said he was only interested in going to rehab to lower his tolerance. He had been doing these drugs since, I don't know, did he say 15? If we believe what he said himself. And one thing is also the music that always comes to my mind. I wonder if Juice WRLD felt the pressure of how people would react to his music if he wasn't on drugs. One rapper that became sober and got a ton of hate, well, it wasn't necessarily hate, but people gave him heavy criticism for his musical quality after he got sober, was Kid Cudi. People were always telling him how great his music was when he was addicted to drugs during Man on the Moon 1 and 2, and comparing his work after that to those two projects. So imagine how that must mess with your mind as an artist. You're doing what's best for your health and getting sober and just as a human being in general living life, but the music that's your living is now being hated by your fans because you're not making the same stuff you were making on drugs. I can't help but feel like a lot of artists run through this scenario, well, a lot of artists that are on drugs, run through this scenario in their head. There's no way to prove that, but if they witness it happen to other artists they grew up listening to, they've gotta at least think about it. And maybe it scares them away from potentially going down the path of sobriety. But let me know what y'all think in the comments. Like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell if you enjoyed. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Peace.